Born in Nebraska in 1886, Andrew Jackson Higgins began his remarkable career by starting a lumber import and export business after moving to New Orleans in 1910. To support his timber company, which frequently retrieved wood from hard-to-reach swamps, Higgins built his own shipyard and service boats. Ultimately, a world decrease in the demand for timber, along with stiff competition, eventually put his timber company out of business. However, in 1930, Higgins survived by expanding his boat building into a full-fledged business endeavor. His main focus was the Eureka boat, which featured a shallow draft, a protected propeller, and a spoonbill bow, which allowed it to run aground and then extract itself without damage, perfect for the heavily swampy marshes of Louisiana. In the late 30s, Higgins began to attract the attention of the U.S. Marine Corps when they were looking for ways to transport troops for amphibious landings. When World War II began, he quickly converted the Eureka to a military landing craft at their request. In 1941, Higgins added a ramp to the Eureka, resulting in the Landing Craft Vehicle Personnel, or LCVP for short. Although Higgins Industries produced a wide variety of watercraft, the LCVP is universally known as the Higgins boat. As World War II progressed, the need for Higgins craft also increased. From less than 100 employees before the war, the manufacturing operation in New Orleans expanded to over 20,000 workers by 1944. The company was innovative at a time when racial discrimination was the law of the land, especially in the Deep South. Higgins offered equal pay for equal work, regardless of race or gender. By the end of its production run, over 22,000 boats of all types with a fully integrated workforce had been produced. Higgins Industries and the LCVP were key components of the Allied victory in World War II. The LCVP could carry 36 men and their equipment onto a hostile beach. The bow ramp allowed the boat to be emptied in seconds, and the LCVP could then extract itself from the beach and go back for another load. The Higgins boat was truly one of the greatest inventions of military warfare, allowing a troop mobility never seen before. Dwight Eisenhower called Higgins the man who won the war for us, while Adolf Hitler angrily referred to him as the new Noah. It was this innovative design from an innovative company in New Orleans, Louisiana, that helped protect the world from tyranny and allowed freedom to triumph.